Assalamu alaikum. Today we will talk about the last part in section 5.1, which is the distance problem. Remember, in this section we talked about the area problem. In fact, we will treat the distance problem the same way we treat the area problem. So let us discuss the distance problem. The distance problem is given as follows. We need to find the distance traveled by an object during a certain time period if the velocity is known at all times. Here we have two cases. Case number one, if the velocity remains constant, then the distance problem will be easy to solve. I mean, the distance will be velocity times the time. Let us understand it here using figures. I know my drawing here is bad. So assume we have this car which is moving with velocity 50 km per hour, and I ask you to find the distance traveled after 10 hours. Well, you will say this is easy. The distance is equal 50 times 10. I mean velocity times the time. So at the end, you will get 500 kilometers. Now, what about this case? If the velocity varies, that means the velocity is changing, then it is not so easy to find the distance traveled. In fact, we will investigate this problem using the following example. I hope you still remember when we discuss the area problem, we consider the case y equal x squared, and we need to find the area under the scale from 0 to 1. Good, then we give a general definition. Now we have the same idea. So let us see this question. He said, given the following table, estimate the distance driven over a 15 seconds time interval. He said here, part A, use the velocity at the beginning of each time period. Let us understand the table first. At time equal to 0, the velocity will be 7 meters per second. At time equal to 5, the velocity will be 10 meters per second, and so on. He said, estimate it using the velocity at the beginning of each time period. So let us draw our time interval. This is 0, this is 5, this is 10, and this is 15. The distance from here to here, delta t, and also from here to here is delta t. We use the letter t because it denotes the time. Now, he said, use the velocity at the beginning. So our beginning in the first interval is 0. Our beginning in the next interval is 5. Our beginning in the last interval is 10. So it's like we are using left endpoints. So I will say here, the distance approximately equal what? It will be delta t times f of these guys. So I will write v because the function is velocity. So it will be v at 0 plus v at 5 plus v at 10. What is the reason for this? Remember, this example, we said what? You need to multiply the velocity times the time. So this is the velocity times the time in each time interval. So these are computations. Let us do it quickly. Delta t is 5. V at 0, you can see it is 7. V at 5, it is 10. And the last one will be 13. This is simple computation. You can do it. This is 150 meter. Great. This is the solution. It is written here. Let us read part B. He said, using the velocity at the end of each time interval. This is the solution, but let us do it together. We will draw the number line first. This is 0, this is 5, this is 10, and this is 15. He said, use it at the end. So our end in the first interval is 5, and our end in the next interval is 10, and our end in the last interval will be 15. So it's like we are using right end points. So here the distance will be approximately delta t times v at these numbers, v at 5, v at 10, plus v at 15, and these are computation. Let us do it quickly. Delta t is 5, v at 5, you can see it is 10, and here we have 13, and here we have 17. If you compute this, you will get 200 meters. And that's it. As we did in the area problem, we motivate the idea by an example. Now we will go to the general definition. Let us see it here. He said, in general, suppose an object moves with velocity v equal f of t greater than or equal to 0, where a less than t less than b. Then the distance can be approximated this way or this way. Here we will use the velocity at the beginning. of each time interval. So we have this figure. Remember, A is called T0. Then if you add delta T, you will get T1, T2, etc., Tn minus 1, Tn. Since we need to use the beginning, we need to treat it like the left endpoint. So we will take all the numbers except the last one on the left. So you will just simply take f of these numbers and do not forget to multiply by delta t each time. And again, what is this? Because we multiply the velocity times the time. If you put it in a compact form, you will get summation from I equal to 1 up to n, f of t I minus 1 delta t. And this is the same definition for left endpoints. Here, part B, we will use the velocity at the end of each time period. So we will treat it like right endpoints. If you need to see it, what is our end here? It is T1. What is our end T2, etc. And our end, the last interval Tn. So just take f of these numbers times delta T. So it will be f of T1 delta T, f of T2 delta T, and f of Tn delta T. And that's it. If you put it in a compact form, you will get this. In general, if you need things to be exact, similar to the area problem, you need to push the number of rectangles to be infinity. Here we will push the number of sub-intervals to infinity. So the distance will be exactly equal to the limit when n goes to infinity, summation f of ti minus 1 delta t, or it is equal to the limit when n goes to infinity, summation I equal to 1 up to n, f of ti delta t. So this is like the definition of the right endpoints, and this is the definition of left endpoints. So we treated the distance problem the same way we treat the area problem. Now we have extra questions. I will leave it to you to solve it. So please solve these three questions and you can see the answer here. Thank you very much.